Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
I think clearly the big takeaway from today's briefing by the Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman is the defense FDI, which has been increased to 74% at an automatic route. And there's a lot of other intent which she has signaled, whether it's coal mining, whether it's the power sector. So in that sense, it is a good briefing, it is a good set of measures. But I think there's a problem here is that a lot of what she has announced is intent. Now, when you had a press conference of this sort, you would expect that there will be no intent, that we have done this, we have done this. So I'll give you some examples. Now, if you look at FDI and defense. Now, the thing is, over the past so many years, Make in India and defense is something the government has talked about for a long, long time. And there has been very little defense production that has taken place in India. Now, that very little production never happened because of the foreign investment levels were at 49%. There were other problems in terms of the procurement taking too long. So I don't know what the FM is going to take to resolve that. Merely increasing 49 to 74 is not going to help that. If you look at another example, so, the Prime Minister, the Finance Minister talked about coal mining and, easier rules for, commercial mining in general. Now, there are two problems here. One is that, firstly, as far as commercial mining in coal is concerned, this is something the government announced one or two, even perhaps more years ago. So it's taken that long, not a single mine has been auctioned. So it's taking too long. Secondly, and the most important part is that on an average, Indian levies for the mining sector are about 40 to 50% more than what they are globally. So if a mining company is given an option of mining in Australia versus mining in India, unless you reduce your levies, nobody's going to come here. And one would have expected that when the finance minister is giving a briefing of this sort, she would have said, we have taken an in-principle decision to cut the levies by this much. We have a district mining fund. There are all kinds of levies that India has. So I think that's very, very unfortunate. On the power sector, again, so we know for a fact that based on what the FM has said, that the SCBs or the DISCOMs in Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, Chandigarh, Pondicherry, we know that these are going to be privatized. But the big reform that we wanted in the power sector was to see, how the losses are going to be reduced, whether tariffs are going to be increased. The FM has said we will have a tariff policy. Once again, it's intent. There is no clarity as yet as to when this will happen. So I think in that sense, today's press conference or today's briefing was good to the extent that it tells you that the government is thinking of some of these things. It was problematic to the extent that you never got a very clear path or you never got very clear numbers on what the way ahead is. And, the thing is, if investment in India is to boom, which is what the Prime Minister wanted, it's going to happen in these sectors. In fact, a very telling comment on this is the head of SpiceJet, Ajay Singh, after he heard the briefing, he made a comment saying, I hope this is not all there is for the aviation sector. So, people have got their hopes pinned on a lot of reforms happening. The FM has announced some today, but it's more intent right now. It's still not policy. So, to that extent, it's a little disappointing.